Those little reeds, you can see all those clear spots in the riverbed.
Yeah, hi, my name's Bruce. In these series of CDs, I'm going to teach you how to tie flies that will catch fish like these ones behind us here. I think I might have just frightened them away. This time of the year, winter time, is the time that you should be stocking up on your flies. Sit back and enjoy these CDs, and I'm sure you'll catch plenty of fish with them, these flies. They vary from reasonably difficult to pretty simple to tie. So enjoy yourself tying them. It's part of it. Enjoy tying them.
Alright, this fly here, Seeker Stimulator, we're going to be tying on size 10 hooks. Long shank. We're going to be using brown mono thread, good sharp pair of scissors, hackle pliers, copper wire, a deer fur stacker, saddle feathers, grizzle and red, hare's fur for the body, seeker hair for the tail and the wing, deer's fur or hair is very buoyant, that's why it makes us such a good dry fly, good glue. Right, we'll set the hook up in the vise, just on the bend. Good and firm, this fly. The hook tends to move about a bit because you've got to pull the mono pretty tight, some of the bindings. Give it a bit of a flick. Hands all right. Take our thread, same as all the other flies we're going to be tying, find a good base, thread along the shank, something for our body to bind to. Very high floating fly, this one. Fish it blind. Good indicator fly. Good cicada imitation. And in some cases, just an all round fly. We've cut the fur off, the deer hairs off. We're going to put it in the stacker. All loose stuff off. I'm just going to give it a few bangs to stack it. What happens is it levels it up, brings it all in line. Like so. About the length of the shank we want for a tail. Hold it on there. You've got to hold the deer fur quite firm. Pull it round. Bind it a couple of times. Just have a look. Displays out. Now we're just going to bind the body lightly to the shank. This will just give it some more buoyancy. Just keep practicing. Now we'll just trim all this hairy stuff off. There you go. Look at it. Now we get a copper wire. Bind a copper wire on there. Copper wires are going to get covered with our hair's fur. Cut the required amount of copper wire off that you think we'll need. Okay. Now, back to our dubbing. In this case here, I haven't got any pre-dubbed mono cotton, so I'm just going to add a bit of dubbing wax. A little pinch of hair's fur and dub it on there. Just twist it. Reasonably firm. The more you do it, the easier it gets. We're going to build the body along about 2/3 of the shank, the hook shank. More. Keep at it. Like with most flies, just the more you do it, the better you get at it. Then we're going to be perfect. I mean, the fish don't think like we do. Now, this is where our saddle comes into it. You want the fibres on your saddle hackle to be about as long as what the hook gap is wide. So what you do here is you just pull it like that and just pull those bits off. Bind it in down here. Just lay it on top there. Wrap around it 3 or 4 times quite firmly. Yep. You can do this with your fingers, but in some cases you makes it easier with the hackle pliers. Hook the hackle pliers on the end of the feather like that. Now we're going to wind it back to the tail. 4 or 5 turns. Spread them apart. like that. Let's six times actually. Now just let that hang down there, then we're going to come back with the cotton. Just move the cotton sideways like that, just to make it go through the hackle. There we are, and bind the other end. Come around. Bit fiddly, but now we're going to come back up the other way with it. Doing the same thing, wiggling it as you go. Now we clip off that saddle hackle. There we go. We're going to bring the copper wire. We're going to turn the copper wire the opposite way to what the hackle is, just for extra bit of binding. We probably don't want this copper wire to be twisted around as many times as that hackle, that saddle hackle. Four, five times, not too many, because this is a dry fly, we want it to float. Too much copper on there, it'll sink. A couple of times up here just to secure it. Clip it, bend it down with the fingernail. Just bind that a few times with the mono thread. Alright, now we're going to make the wing. Cut a clump of deer's fur, or hair, beg your pardon. Probably your about that thick. And just cut that off. We'll put that in the stacker. There we have the finished product. All nice and even on the edge there. This is our wing. We're going to lay it here. About the same length as the tail feather. Pinch it. Sorry, same length as a tail fur here. I get mixed up between fur and hair. Deer hair and hair fur. Okay, it's probably about 1 centimeter long. We're going to lay it, we're going to bind it right where we finished making the body, or where we started winding our hackle back. That's where we're going to bind it there. We want it to come and hang to about there. Okay, there you go, it's a pinch loop. Put it down, one turn, two turns, have a quick look at it. If I'm happy with that, roll it over, yep, looks good enough to me. Now we'll just firmly bind it. We've got to be very careful where we go here, just a couple of times. We don't want to go right up to the eye, we want to leave at least 1.5 mil from the eye. Could have had that a bit longer. Wait a minute. Cook it off. Just tidy up around there a bit. Firm it up. Now, our grizzle hackle. See how hairy it looks. It's good because it'll make it float. Okay, here's our grizzle. Do the same as what we've done with the red one. Like that. Pull it off. Bind it in there. Reasonably firm. Okay, now we're going to dab a little bit more hair's fur on there now. It's better to be a bit sparingly because you can add, it's easier to add than to take off. Just don't keep going over the top of itself, like that. Go down, remember that mil and a half I was just talking about? Right, and then we're going to go around, probably two, maybe three times with this. One. Two. That looks good. Tie it off there. Caught a lot of fish with this fly. A lot of fish. Clip it off. We'll just bind a little bit more, form a reasonable sort of a head. Half loop. And finger hitch. Two, three, four, and five up. Pull it. Bit of glue. There you go. And then we get the tail end of one of the hackles. And clean out the eye. That's it. That is our finished product. Seeker hair stimulator. Real high floater. Good indicator fly. Brilliant fly. Let's go and find the river now. See how it gets on. I'm sure it won't let us down.
video, will you? Probably won't hit the old 1-2-3 here, they can play shallow.
That's right. That was perfect.
Very beautiful, didn't it?
It did, it came up a treat. That's a nice fish. A sucker for those deceivers, aren't they? Yeah, you think they're done in, but they're not. They've still got a bit of life in them.
And my rules to make a fish count for land, it's got to be touched. I touched it.
Good on you. Tag, you're it.
Not a skunk today.
That's a cracker, Bruce. A beautiful fish. Well done.
An old fish.
Well, that was the best fish in the pool. I think so.
You're close to 6 p.m.
Yeah, he would be too. A nice fish.